Hi everyone, how are you doing? I hope you had a great weekend, a sunny weekend as it was here. Today we will look into web mentions, at least that's my plan. So, what are web mentions? Web mentions is basically a web standard for mentions and conversations across the web. Basically, what you can do, it's basically like you have your blog post, and well, you see it here. You have your blog post, and then below, you see comments, but also you can see other mentions, like when people are basically retweeting your tweet about it or responding on Twitter on that topic. So that all gets gathered in this web mentions view that you can design your own. It's more of how the data comes, gets to this point to your page. And the web mentions is something that the indie web or more or less brought up. So what is the indie web? I will paste this in the chat as well. It's basically a people-focused alternative, as they write here, to the corporate web. Yeah, I can also paste this video. I will encourage you to look at this video by Hayden Pickering. In general, on his previous video, he has a lot of nice videos that yeah, are worth to have a look at about the web. And please support him if you haven't. It's really, the videos are basically on point and really, for me, they are very funny. Okay, but today, yeah, we want to look into web mentions. I would like to look into web mentions because I have my blog, and basically I would like to have web mentions working with my blog. And yeah, until now I have no idea how to do that. So there are different examples. Jeremy Keith also has web mentions on his page. No, that was a link. Let's see, let's go on a blog post and you see the responses. And here you see that's posted by Andy Bell. And you see the status code is from Twitter, so it's basically a Twitter response. So basically, this tweet from Andy Bell goes into the blog like a response, which is pretty nice. Because you don't need to comment on the blog itself, you can comment on social media everywhere. And it will be in there. You also see the likes, most probably also from Twitter. Yeah. And that's pretty nice. I would like to have something similar. But first we need to understand how this works. Publishing software, well, my blog is custom all and all. So yeah, there is something which is called, so there needs to be something which is aggregating the things. Let's close this again. So there must be something that is aggregating the links in some kind of service that sends them to the blog itself. So is this Lobsters? It's an open source technology focused link aggregation service. Ah, okay, that's another approach to basically get a list of interesting blog posts by aggregating the web mentions. but I'm searching for service for publishers to handle receiving and sending webmanage. Exactly, that's what we are searching for. So everyone that has a blog is basically a publisher and needs to handle the receiving and sending web mentions for their site or using web mentions for additional services. So there's Pritchy. Okay, let's close all this. There's Pritchy, a service that sends web mentions for comments, replies, likes, and reposts on Twitter, Flickr, GitHub, Mastodon, and Instagram posts. Okay. Well, there is this, well, there's a lot of, okay. Buzeda. It's a web mention receiver, which publishes web mentions as comments. It's modular design support publishes the multiple commenting systems, but currently only a plugin for ISSO. Okay, it's something like commenting server. Okay. And then there's WebMention, it's another popular one. It's an open source project and hosted service for receiving WebMentions and pingbacks on behalf of your indie website. So, Pretty connects your website to social media likes, retweets, mentions, course posting, and so on. Connect your accounts. So how does this work? I could connect now with Twitter or something, but what? So it's then using my Twitter feed to gather the data, or what is it doing? So it's basically using my accounts on the social media platforms and gathering data. Okay. You might also be interested in reading about this project. Yes. Okay. So here I could sign in with my address, and then let's make this bigger. And then on your site you can use link web mention. You put in your username web mention, and pingback you put this in with your username. The system will begin collecting web mentions and pingbacks on your behalf. Of course, you can leave the pingback endpoint if you would like. If you want to accept pingbacks on your website but don't want to deal with the hassle of XML RPC, what does this mean? Extensible markup language remote procedure call. Which uses encode its calls and HTTP as transport mechanism. The XML RPC protocol was created in 1998 by Dave Weiner of Userland Software and Microsoft, with Microsoft seeing the protocol as an essential part of scaling up its efforts in business-to-business e-commerce. Okay. An example of a typical XML RPC request would look like, okay, a method call, method name, parameter, and then you get a response, okay. Okay, so that means we get XML back as a format. Display mention counter. You can use the API from JavaScript to display a mention count of one or more URLs. Getting the data manually. Okay, so they have an API behind WebMention.io. And you can say, okay, it's JSON. So you could say API endpoint, give me the likes. No, dimensions of this page of my blog example.com, and it will give you the count. And you see the type of mentions, whether it's a bookmark, a mention. Displaying counts automatically. You can include some simple markup in the JavaScript file to automatically display the mention counter for one or more URLs on the page. Okay, so that seems they seem to have some JavaScript library that is basically can help you basically replacing these elements with real data. But I don't want to do that. I want to do that my own. You can also use the API to show all mentions of a URL. Exactly, that's what you want to do. This will work with jQuery, or you can use the API directly from a server. Yeah, I'm not going to use jQuery. Okay, so what's now the difference? API count, and here it is. Mentions. JF2. What is JF2? JF2 is a working prototype of a simpler JSON serialization. Okay. Never heard of that. Never heard of JF2. Okay, how, where we are here. Okay, so we, okay, that's basically just something else for JSON. And we get back type feed, name, web mentions, children. So we get an entry with an author. A URL published. Okay. Okay, published. Content, and then you get the tweet of the guy or something. Okay. Okay, so let me try me this out. I will try to. I will try to sign in. So that's my blog. Ah, I need first a URL me link, okay. Ah, okay, I understand. So they use, okay. So they use, so there is something called URL me microformats. That basically says, so you have to put it on your website, and basically that says, hey, I'm the website owner, and that's me on Twitter. And then you basically have the connection between the social media accounts and your blog. So what they're doing, I tested that now, so when you try to set in, it is looking for these Realme links on your page, on your page you're entering here, to see whether you have a Twitter account or something. And then they basically, yeah, if they find something, they try to authenticate you with this, with Twitter or something. Okay, so that means we first have to... So I currently have some Realmes on my page, which is, I think, for those here. Yeah, you see, I have these links for Twitch, YouTube, LinkedIn, but not for Twitter on the page. So first we will need to put this on my page, and then we could try to log into Web Mentions again. Then I would need to try to add those those links, and then I would try to grab the API and return something. Yeah, looks like it would be something like that. So yeah, in case you just stepped into my stream, so I'm trying to, so I have a blog or some website, say it like that, and I'm trying to integrate Web Mentions, which is basically something like, do we have an example still open? Let's take Jeremy again, Jeremy's page. What? Where is he? Ah, here. Let's take a blog post. So that's a blog post of Jeremy Keith. I don't know if you don't know this guy. Check him out. Jeremy is an expert in the web in general, I would say. And you see here responses, and you see here that some guy, Andy Bell, is another great guy, responded something to this post. And actually this response did not happen because Andy Bell typed something into a comment area on the blog post itself. It was basically doing that on Twitter. So when you click on the link, it's basically a Twitter post, a tweet. And that got gathered into responses, the same for Brett Frost, Matt Castillo, and so on. So that means you don't need to have a comment area like usually under your blog post. You basically just share your blog post on the web, on the social media platforms like Twitter or Facebook. And then whoever is responding to these posts will pop up in this under your post, which is simply pretty nice. Okay, let's first look into the Realme. So we need, I think WebMentions.io is not working. So it's not neither working with Twitch, YouTube, or LinkedIn. I am 100% sure it will work with Twitter. I'm not sure if it will work with something else. Not sure where I could find this information. It's the same like Twitchy, basically. Or is it the same? I don't know. So I still don't get, Twitchy is another service. I still don't get what is the exact difference between WebMention.io and Twitch.gy. Let's see. Put you whenever a link is posted, put your polls for replies. I set up my to receive web mentions on a third party service, webmention.io. Webmention.io stores web mentions on their server so I can retrieve them to display on my blog. It also acts as a spam filter, make mentions from bots will filter out so they won't appear under my posts. Okay, so someone tweets a link to one of my posts or interacts with the tweet with a tweet that contains a link, one link or many links to one of my posts. Pritchy polls Twitter and discovers the interaction. Pritchy posts a web mention to my website. The web mention is brought to webmention.io and stored. Ah, okay. So Pritchy is something on top of webmention.io. So Pritchy is taking care of pulling the data from Twitter, and webmention is basically just handling the receiving and to easily receive webmentions. It's just the receiving part of webmentions. So, and Pritchy creates the web mention in the end. Okay, understood. I think I understood. And then you could do something like this. Okay, this one has no web mentions. I think I understood. So we need both web mention and Pritchy. That means first I need to have a reference to Twitter, to my Twitter account. So to my Twitter URL. Well, for the sake of simplicity, we can just put it in the header as before. Well, I will need to look into how to display them properly. But then let's do that. Okay, I think it's in meta. No, it's not in meta. Where is it? Ah, it's link outs. So here we already have some Realme links. I just add one for my Twitter profile. Okay. Yep, that's me. Okay, then this means this can go. Twitter link out. Okay, push the stuff. That means in some minutes it should be on production on the website. And then we need to log into WebMentions and Pretty. Well, Pretty I maybe can already do, let me see. Okay, it says it's this mean you need WebMention support. Okay, that might be interesting. Wait, I try to share this with you. So it basically already looks in my Twitter for WebMentions, and it sees that basically I have this posting about one of my blog posts about CSS Flexbox, and it sees that someone is basically has somebody, I don't know, probably retweeted this tweet. And it says basically no WebMention support because it says that my, it sees that my blog doesn't have WebMention set up now. Because in the end, what's missing is exactly that part that WebMention.io is doing. It's missing this stuff. These links are missing. So I think when these links are there, it will work. So that means Pretty is already more or less good to go. Then let's see. Now it should be there. Okay, now you see Twitter is available. So now I would like to try to log into WebMentions. So I have to do this off screen, but in principle I'm logging now into WebMentions. I'm doing this stuff here. Okay. Okay, it worked. Now. Okay, now that worked. Now that means we can, I got the list of those links. So that means now we can add these links. I need to add them to templates. Head content. Wait, where I am. Meta. Yeah, we need to add this to Meta. So we make a section for web maintenance. And I add these two links that I got from webmention.io. Okay. Okay, now this worked. Let's push this. Okay, that means when they are pushed to my blog post, to my blog, that means from this moment on, we should be ready to go. So webmention.io will know that my blog is ready because they are in. And also Pudgy will know it. So Pudgy is the service that is generating the web mentions, and webmention.io is basically responsible for fetching the web mentions. Well, basically making them accessible via their API. And then what we would have to do is basically write JavaScript to fetch the mentions per blog post, and then we'll show something there. And I think somewhere now it's about testing this, because I don't want to retweet my tweets all day to test it. And there seems to be a Firefox add-on for doing that. Oh, come on, it's no longer there. Okay, there seem to be other services. Source, target. It's Telegraph. Well, let's see. If somebody has some idea to how to test web mentions, let me know. Okay, now if we go back to the page, we should see in the head, we should see the links to the web mentions. Okay. Now that means if I reload Pudgy now, let's see. Now, in principle, everything should be set up. in principle. So this means now we could start writing some JavaScript to fetch the data. So the idea would be behind or below each blog post, or maybe even in the details, I don't know. Well, basically somewhere under each blog post page to have the web mentions showing up. Somewhat like it is for for the general pages that we saw. So how can we test it? Okay, now let's go a bit into code. Let's go a bit into code. That means we are in the blog post template. That's the template I'm using for my blog posts. And well, the blog post extends the main template. Which has a main content, and in there is having the article, and I think the microdata thingy is it's the microdata, sure. Here's the details section about the blog post. So that's basically this area top here. That's the details element. If you don't know the details element, it's an HTML5 element that basically holds all details about a page. So I named this about this post. It comes automatically, I think, in every browser with this toggleable state. So you can collapse it and uncollapse it. And then in there I have, well, basically a definition list like, okay, this article is written at this time, at this date, or even when it was updated or something. So it's written and it's updated. So below there we could do something for the JavaScript part. I think I used preact. Yeah, I used preact. But where did I do this? For the quotes, okay. Yeah, so we could define something like, I don't know, at the bottom of each article. Well, I don't know, can I have a footer inside an article tag? I cannot write footer in article. Footer represents the footer of the newest sectioning content. So okay, what is section? Content category is permitted content. Permitted parents. Any element that accepts flow content, note that a footer element must not be descended of address, header, or another footer element. It's not. represents a footer of its new section in content. Section in content is what? Exactly, article. So that would be possible. We do a footer element inside the article. And then we say here section and we give it the ID webmentions. And then we could say we make a JavaScript snippet webmentions. And we do the same as we do for quotes. No, we don't do that. And we do this for web mentions. So we inject the React component into the web mentions section container. And we say it's not this one, it's what is it? Web mentions list. Well, there's a lot of boilerplate still there. It's web mentions list, and then what do we have to do? We will have to fetch the web mentions IO API endpoint, and then return a rendered list or something. So for now we will just put there, I don't know, an H2 web mentions, and we have to start the machines. And then somewhere we have to include it here into our index file as mentions list. Okay. Oh, let's call it web mentions. And so now if I go to this page, that here, I see another problem. How do I test web mentions locally on localhost? Okay, that's another problem. Document get element by the web mentions. It's correct, no? Web mentions. it's not even getting there. Maybe I have to restart. What's wrong? Sentry fails and then the rest fails. Yeah, of course. Well, let's document sentry out for a second. So sentry, if you don't know that, it's basically a service for application monitoring. So you can see which kind of things go wrong on your project. So basically it has all the client errors, but also for server side. So you can basically see the errors where they're happening. And well, I haven't configured it correctly on my front end here, on my local one. Okay, now it works. Target DOM element is there. And so I get the H2. Okay, now it would be about fetching the data. The question is, how do I test web mentions locally? That's not completely clear to me. Web mentions implementation guide. Well, it should not make a difference. Because I can use the live API endpoint of the live with the API key of the live website. I see there's another thing like telegraph. And that's for sending web mentions. Okay, web mention I was for easily receiving. And telegraph seems to be something for sending. So I also need telegraph. And Pritchy is using that or what? So Pritchy needs to send web mentions, and I assume it's using this telegraph service, which I haven't configured yet. So my fear is that I also need this one. Let me also open the specification. Okay. Sending web mentions, receiving web mentions. Sending web mentions, create a source document that mentions the target. So like a Twitter post, or a source could also be a Twitter post or something. But it can also be another HTML site that links to another page and says this is a great post. Sender discovers receiver web mention endpoint. The sender must fetch a target URL and check for an HTTP link header, yeah, with a URL value of web mention. This we have in place. So in our head we have a link URL web mention. If the content type of the document is HTML, the sender must look for an HTML link and a element with a URL value of web mention. If more than one of these is present, the first HTTP link header takes precedence, followed by the link, the first link or H element in the document order. Senders must support all the options and fallback in this order. Okay. Example 2. So he's trying to get this post by Aaron, which is referenced here. And it returns the web mention link URL. Sender notifies the receiver. The sender must post blah blah source and target parameters to the web mention endpoint, where source is the URL of the sender's page containing a link and target is the URL of the page that being linked to. Okay, so basically if I understand that Pritchy is some kind of sender and Pritchy needs Telegraph, which is able to send web mentions, so it's taking the token, a source and a target. That means we also need a Telegraph account. Okay. Let's see, how do I get started there? Log in. Your web address. Okay. Okay, now I'm in there. But what do you do with it now? What do you do with Telegraph? What a super feeder. Easily send web mentions from your website. Oh, I see something working. So I see in Twitch now, in Twitch I basically clicked on this. Wait, can I show it again? Yeah, I think I can. I clicked again on this tweet that someone sent with a link to my blog post, and it seems to send something. So now, if I'm not completely mistaken, we can go. Yeah, it's there, it's working. So we got our first web mention. And it's basically related to it's related to this tweet, to this post. So now it's about using the web mention IO API. This one here. So we are not interested in the counter, I'm interested in the show all mentions. So I want to do that. Okay, let's try to do that. Let's try to do that. So basically, we want to do that. So let's go back to, where's my code? Yeah. So we are here. Okay. So here and we are in our web mention list. Now, as first, we need to fetch the web mentions API endpoint. Well, we have this jQuery code, but we will do this with fetch API. So we will do a fetch. The URL is this one. GetJSON. Oh, what is the syntax of jQuery GetJSON? What is the second one? Data. The data. It's a plain object or string. So it's basically the body of our get. Oh wait, is it a get or is it a post? No, it's a post. No, it's a get request. So then we need to. Send it with the query string, no? So we need a window location href. That's our target, because that's our current page we are on. So we need to say here target. To make this a template rule. Something like that. And then we get some data or some response. We get the JSON format and then we have our data. And then at this point, let's debug this a bit. Or we catch an error. So what do? We fetch the web mentions IO API, we fetch dimensions, and the target website we are interested in is the blog post we are on, which is windowlocation.href. So let's try this out. It will not work for now with the local one. So here we are locally, let's try this out. I think it will not work. Okay, let's remove that. Okay, we get something back, data, children, and there's nothing in. Exactly. Now I know we got web mentioned for for one live page, I got a web mention, so that means if I use now if I use this page, so we got a web mention for this page, which is the production one on my production website on my blog post. So if you're not using for now, if you're not using if you're not using window location href, so let's say page is this one. And we comment out this one. Oops. So if we patch that for a second and say we take it for the current page, that is this live one, we should actually get something back. Let's try. Yes, it looks good. We get children back. And we get the data back. And it's the one from Twitter. From Sasha. And it's basically this text. And that's what we want to have. That means it's working. It's working. We're getting the data back, and now it's basically the last part is the part that is up to you how you want to use this information. Okay, let's go back to their documentation. What they say about the format? So it has type entry here. What's the type? In our example, yeah, it's type entry. Okay, so it's data children. It's an entry, type entry. URL is basically the mentioned URL. So in this situation, a Twitter tweet. It has a content as text. I don't know, web mention, okay, that's web mention ID, that's internal stuff, it's received. And the source is from Twitchy. Exactly, so Twitchy? The Twitchy service was sending the data. So what we can do is basically doing a So what do we want to do? Well, we want to use state. Per default it's an empty array. It's an empty array, and when we get data, check data.children. And if there are children, then we say mentions. So if we have some mentions, which is if we have data.children, we set mentions and we take the existing mentions and we push, we append data.children into. And in this case we Well, let's not catch the error, because then it will pop up in Sentry if there's an error. That means now we should have a mentions in there. And we could do something like this. So we have an ordered list. And for each mention, what do we do? Well, let's start a simple thing, data. Let's just print the data. Okay. Okay, something failed. Fragment is not defined. How do we do it here? How do we use fragment in preact? Mansions.map is not a function. Why it's not a mention? Why is it not possible? Let's lock dimensions. Oh, it's one. What? Ah, I'm stupid. Okay, mentions push is not working because it's basically push is returning the array length. So we need to say spread the current and the new ones. Oh, it never stops. What did I do? Ah, I need to use hook, of course, use effect. And I only want to do that on start. Because otherwise it will do the fetch whenever the component gets re-rendered. Okay, so now here we have our data. We have the author. Well, we have an author. We have a photo. Say content text. So we could say something mention.author.name. Says and then quotes and then mention dot content text. And we have a web mention, Sasha Metz says. And then we need the link to it again. What was the link? Photo URL. some nice rendering. Author type card name. URL, okay, we could send. Target plank. Mention.url. So in case you're just joining right now, I'm working on integrating web mentions, so so-called web mentions, into my blog. So I have a blog, and basically web mentions is what it's saying. It's mentions of your blog posts on the web, which could look like something, I don't know. Let's do some example here again. You see something like this one, it has 11 replies, and then basically these replies are not actually things. These are not actually replies on the blog post that are made on the blog post itself, but on Twitter, on Facebook, on social media in the end, and also some kind of likes or something. Well, the likes, I did not, haven't found out how this is done. Let's see. So I think I still need to figure this out. Where's my... So we have here a type entry. Not sure what it will be in another type. If it's a like, if it's another in, it, another type, I think so. Let me try this out. Okay, I think I found another thing. Let me see. Okay, now I think we should have like as well. Let's see, now we should have two mentions. Exactly. Okay, like off. Okay. Type entry. Well, unfortunately, both are entries. I wish there would be a different type. Like of, repost of. Well, I think these are things that are related to the service which we are using, which is sending the web mentions, which is Pretty. Not sure, do we see it here? Repost off. Ah, okay. Exactly. What do we have as options here? Okay, we could have a comment which is in reply to. So if we have, if it's a comment, it has this field in reply to. If it is a like, it has the field like off. If it is a repost, it is a repost of. Okay, we need to do... self entity type. Yeah, I don't understand why the type is always entry. That's a bit unfortunate. I wish this would be type, I don't know, like, and this would be type reposting or something. That means, what do we need to do now? Well, we have this link here. That means we need to map this to something. Well, let's make a function web mention. It gets the data. And then here we do a switch. No, that's not possible. Cannot use switch because those are different fields. Those are different fields. So what do we need to do? We need to find out the type of mention related to this code they have for putG service. And then render accordingly. So I think we need some if blocks. So we say type is most probably it will be a repost. If data has in reply to then set the type to comment. Well, this sucks a bit. If data has the field like of, the type is like, what did I do wrong? I'm mixing things today. If it's like of, then it's type like, otherwise it's repost. And then here we can do a switch. Well, actually no, it's actually too much. Repost case. So here, like. Return something comment. So what I want to do, so this code is only for repost. This is for repost. Question is, do we want to probably when we want to categorize the web mention. So we want to have all the reposts, then all the likes, and so on. Well, let's start simple. Let's start with that. So for the repost case, we want to return what we already did. Let's call this mention. If it is like, so if it is a comment, then it's more appropriate to say, this guy says, If it is a repost, we just say reposted this blog post. And if it's a like, we say we had a problem that it had no URL, right? No text. Okay, so the URL we always have. No, we don't have the URL. Mentioned URL. We don't have a. So for like, we don't have a URL, right? No, we don't have text. Okay, so we already. So we have a URL and we say. Liked this. And here we say, reposted that. And here we say, says, or commented. And now if I use this web mention here. We just do that. What is the outcome? Cannot read name of undefined. Let's see. Wait a second. This is a prop, of course. Okay, it says Sasha liked this and Sasha reposted this. Okay, wait, the URL is a bit weird. Well, there's a lot to simplify on this, but I just want to get something working right now. Okay, and the liking, the thing is basically favored by. Okay, in case of favoriting. I'm just interested in the author URL because I'm not interested in what he favored. So which tweet he favored. So in case of like, we take the author URL. So we link to his profile, yeah. And here we link to his tweet. Okay. That looks not too bad. Well, all this logic is a bit unfortunate because the type is in both cases, whether it's a tweet repost or also retweet or a favorite, it's both entry, which is a bit unfortunate. But this comes through pretty. Content value. If not text, content value. Okay, he says reply this, blah blah blah, okay. Wait, we have this in there? Okay, yeah, that's a bit unfortunate. So they handled the type somewhat different. Add replies, add mentions. Okay, I will have to look a bit into that. I don't know. Well, I'm using it. I'm using this service the first time. I'm already quite happy that I got it working. So I see Sasha Metz, oh, like this, reposted this. It's already quite nice. So let's say okay, well, I would say that's enough for now. Now the point is, what if we don't have any web mentions? So let's get back here. So the current page, let us switch this. So until now we looked at this product, no, my blog post, which is live, which has a web mention. But now let's look at the local the local posts that don't have web mentions. So it says nothing. So we should have something here. Mentioned length greater zero. We say we list them, otherwise we say, I don't know. One mentioned this blog post. On the set face. Or we basically just could do this. Yeah, let's make it simple. Let's just render this if there are web mentions. So if we return nothing, there will be nothing shown. And it's using the window location href. And that should be it for now. That means if I push this now to live, hey, hi Monte. I feel like you're overcomplicating that code. Yeah, probably I do. I'm basically trying to use web mentions. So web mentions is a web standard for getting mentions of your blog post on the web. So that means if someone is tweeting about your blog post, you will get a mention of this on your post. And what I do basically here is I fetch the data and I'm using, because this is something I have to do anyhow with JavaScript, I need to fetch the data from an API endpoint. I will have to use JavaScript anyhow. Well, I could definitely do that with barebone JavaScript, but I have already preact as lightweighter React alternative in place. So basically, what I do is I fetch the data, and if there are no mentions, I do nothing, and if there are mentions, then I will basically show them. Below the regular blog post, which is already server-side rendered HTML. So I'm basically, no, not server-side, I'm even, it's a static web page, and just the web mentions will be something that preact will do a fetch request. And yeah, in case there is something, we'll show the mentions. I kind of go on Twitch to get away from coding. Yeah, that's totally fine. I normally also do that. I also listen or watch gaming on Twitch. So yeah, I can totally understand that. Okay, but that means if I would now deploy this, that should more or less work. So we added in our trig template, we added a footer section called web mentions as an ID, and basically Preact is rendering itself into this container and doing the fetch requests to the web mention IO service to see if there are any web mentions for this target URL, which is the window location.href. And if there is, basically it will add it to the mentions, and basically it will print it here. That means if I do this assets, so what we did, we are rendering web mentions on blog posts. So if I push that now, it should probably work. Let's see. So yeah, that was quite interesting. I don't know if anybody of you has web mentions in place, but it's a really neat alternative of having a block where you have to insert some kind of commenting service where you comment below the actual blog post, but more using what's anyhow in place, because you are anyhow, if you are on social media, and then if I tweet about my newest blog post and you like it, it's already some kind of interaction with this blog post and some kind of mention. So let's see if this works. That would be the goal of my stream being done with that. So basically having web mentions in place, and then it's basically all about how to render them, how to show them, that's then the next thing to do. But yeah, the building blocks are in place. So basically we use two services. Let me show you again. So we are using Pritchy, which is basically pulling my Twitter feed and basically looks for interactions, or basically Pritchy is looking all the way through Twitter for tweets where my blog or one blog post of mine is mentioned. Monte, thanks anyhow for the follow. That's really nice. Thanks for that. So basically Pritchy is pulling through Twitter, the Twitter tweets, and looks for mentions of my blog or my blog posts, and then it's basically sending web mentions on behalf of Twitter. So it's basically sending a web mention that someone tweeted or retweeted my tweet or tweeting about my blog post, and then there is web mention IO, which is basically for receiving web mentions. So web mention IO will then receive the web mentions and store them in their service. And then basically there's my blog post itself, which will then fetch the web mention IO API to basically show them on the page actually. So yeah, if I would follow the general rule of indie web, basically doing everything on your own, I mean, then I would have to define those services on my own, because these are still services. So if Twitchy tomorrow says they're gone, they will no longer go ahead. The question is, will there be some alternative to Twitchy? I mean, yeah, they're all on the... I think they're all open source services, so you can see the source on GitHub and so on. Someone could fork it and do another service doing the same thing. But yeah, it's not fully indie web, I would say. So let's see if I go now here. No. Maybe something got wrong. Still nothing here. Let me see what's going on. Oh, it failed. Why did it fail? Could not resolve web mentions from assets jails index. Okay, I fucked something up. Web mentions. Did I not commit? Oh, I did not commit it. Nice. I did not commit the file. Let's repush it. Yeah. Okay. That should hopefully work. Oh, I found another problem. Sentry has to be activated again. Okay, that means in some minutes we should see this thing working, and then, yeah, that's a first step to get it working. And then basically, yeah, I have to check a bit this code again. Also, this is no longer needed now. I'm not using this anywhere. Let's clean this up. Yeah, it's a bit unfortunate that there is no... that Twitchy is not sending different types for different meanings. So if it's a reply, it's the same type. It's both entry type. But they don't have different fields. So if it's a comment, then it has the in reply to field. If it is like, it has a field called like dash off, and well, otherwise it's a repost, and that's a bit unfortunate. It would be better to have some kind of type, and then it's either comment, repost, or like. And I don't understand why they do not provide it, because they have to use something like that anyhow, logically, internally. Um, Let's push that again. And then let's see. And it's working. I have some bracket left there, but in principle this is a blog post that has web mentions, and you see it working. Sasha is liking this, and Sasha reposted that on Twitter. And that's true. So the person that retweeted that is Sasha. So why do I have this curly bracket? It's this one. Okay, but that's working, and if a blog post does not have any web mention, it's not appearing at all. But for this one it's there. And in the end it's a get call to the web mention API. And yeah, the thing that I don't like, it's basically that, so these things come from Pucci. Ah, okay, there is the web mention property. Okay. So instead of type, which I would have said is the type of thingy, it's this web mention dash property that says it's a like, it's a repost. So basically this web mention property, I don't know what it says. It's basically the it's referencing to the field that contains more data about it. Okay, that would be easier, so I could use the web mention property without knowing exactly what this means. Web mention property Pucci. What? No. Okay, let's fix that. So we go. We do a switch here. But mention dot web mention property. And if it's in reply to, there's the case like of, and then there's the default case, which is repost. We return this, and per default we return this. that would be it, no? So we check the WebMention property and we go case by case. Let's try this again. So the page we want to test is this one, because that already has web mentions. That means dev. Okay, it's still running. Sentry again. Okay, and that's working as well. So we have a like. And we have a repost case. Cool, that also works. And it's a bit clearer. Basically a clean switch case. Yeah, this link we should keep. So what we did is basically rendering a web mention based on switch case of web mention property. Cool. That works now. That's quite nice. Cool, that means we basically started using web mentions. We're using Pritchy to generate web mentions, send web mentions based on Twitter or Facebook or whatever social media, And then basically we use, let me put this in chat, we're using Pretty to send the web mentions, and we're using webmention.io to receive web mentions, and we then use webmention.io API to gather the data and show something nice on our blog posts about the web mentions. And that works. And then basically what's left to be done is for everyone how to style the web mentions on your own design, on your blog posts. And well, basically the one I have now is basically pretty simple. But that's more or less it, so it's working. And if we have no web mentions, nothing is shown. It's nice. It's a beginning. And from there we can go. In principle we have data to show profile pictures of the people, so I could also add a profile picture here of Sasha in the page, but yeah, for simplicity reasons I did not do that until now. But okay, that's it. We are going to rate one now. So who we are going to rate? Who is streaming? Who is streaming right now? So let's see. So we have who do we have? Professional grade beginner who's learning to programming. Let's see, we are going to host him. I wish you all a nice evening. We see each other on Tuesday for another TypeScript lesson. There's also the TypeScript command. Check it out. We see each other on Tuesday. Bye bye.